Before watching this video, please subscribe this channel and click on bell icon to get the notifications for the upcoming classes.
Calculate. I want to show an example. So estimate the length of here. Estimate the length of 1.5 centimeter dia stock. So here stock purchased from the shop of diameter of 1.5 centimeter, that is 15 mm. 1.5 centimeters are 15 mm dia stock required to hand forge. Here it is very important, hand forge. So it is clearly mentioned that hand forge of 1100 pieces. So 1100 pieces of rivets. So 1100 pieces of rivets as shown in figure. Here figure is given, as shown in figure. Also calculate the cost of forging at the rate of 20 rupees 20 per meter square of the surface area to be forged. Here this is the actual object given. This is the dimensions of the rivet. So this is estimate the length of. So how much length of the bar should be to be purchased from the shop. So that is it is asked to estimate the what is the length of the bar to be purchased. So that is the length of the diameter of the stock is 1.5 centimeters. So to make 1100 pieces. So here it is very clear that the dimensions of the rivet is given as a 1250 volumes, that is one cylinder. This is the segment of spear. So then the net volume of this rivet can be calculated as a volume of the cylinder, as you know that. So 5 by 4 d square into l, that is 5 by 4 d is the 12. So it's only, that is 5 by 4 12 square plus length 5 by 4 d square into l, that is 5654 mm cube. So volume of segment of spear, for the volume, this is the volume of segment of spear. There are different formulas available for the volume of segment of spear whenever the r is given, whenever the this diameter is given. So there are two types of, whenever the diameter used for the calculation of volume, that is 5h by 6 into 3 by 4, this is the d1 square plus h square, this is the h height. So whenever the r is given, that is the radius of this top surface, that is pi h square by 3 into 3r, this is the r, 12 is given as a r, in minus h when r is given. I used this formula only, that is pi h square by 3 into 3r minus h, as h is equal to 7, r is equal to 12. So then I applied this formula pi. Here I used it, but I am not preferring in units of meters, that then I place it in mm. So pi h square, pi into h is the height, 7 square by 3. So 3r, 12 minus 7, it is 1488.06 mm square. So the net volume, this volume is 5654, and this is the volume of segment of spear 14. The net volume is 7142.93 meter cube. Now whenever the calculation of net volume is over, then it is go to calculate the gross volume by considering the losses. That is the, here it is clearly mentioned that this is the hand forging. So hand forged, it is clearly given that hand forged. So hand forging, only scale and shear loss is considered. Here scale loss is taken as a 5%, shear loss is taken as a 6%, or sometimes it taken as a 0.2 centimeters of the given stock. But here I considered only the shear loss as a 6%. Here scale loss is 5% of the gross volume, that is the net volume, that is 5 by 100 into 7142.90, this is 352.14. next, shear loss is 6%, that is 6% of the net volume, that is 428. Then now you can calculate the gross volume by adding net volume plus the losses, that is net volume 47142 plus the scale loss 357 plus shear loss 428. So after adding up all these net volume and losses, you can get the gross volume. So then the length of stock required. So the length of stock, as I already explained you, the length of stock required is equal to gross volume of the rivet by cross section of the stock. Gross volume of the rivet is 7927.71 mm³, and the cross section of the stock, this diameter must be the stock which is stock from the shop, that is given as a 1.5 centimeter. Here all the dimensions are taken in mm only, that's why I convert this 1.5 centimeters into 15 mm, that is 15. This is the cross sectional area of the stock, so 5/4 d². So once calculate, it is obtained that 44.86 mm per rivet. So the length required for completion of one rivet is 44.86 mm. So here it is asked to calculate the 1100 pieces. So it is 1100, that is 44.86 into 1100, that is 49.347 mm, that is 49.34 meters of stock is length of stock is required. Next one is the cost of surface forge. So here another data is given, cost of surface, it is also the cost of forging at the rate of 20 rupees 20 per meter square. Here so cost of forging, so here a pressure is applied this side, here this is the forging cost, here all hand forging is, here forging is hand forged, all this here the area of hand forge can be calculated. Here the area is fiber cross sectional area, this is the surface area, this is the cross sectional area, this is the surface area, this area of the cross sectional for area of the this part is 5/4 d². Here hand forge pi dl, here this part, this is like this, that's why 5/4, this big d square minus small d square, here pi d into length of height of the segment of sphere. So here surface area can be calculated as the 5/4 d, here 5/4 d², this is the pi dl, this is the 5/4 big D square minus small d square. So in this way you can calculate the surface area to be forged, that is the hammering, the pressure applied on these parts, that is the, so total volume placing the values here which is given in the actual figure, so you can simply obtain the it is taken as a, whenever you put the values in mm, so that is 2638.79 mm² per rivet. For 1100, that is 2638.79 into 1100 pieces of rivets, that is, so then whenever you hear the, well, the cost of forging are 20 per meter square, here meters, but here we calculated in mm square, so mm square can be converted into meter square by dividing 10 to the power of 6, that is 1000 into 1000, it is 2.9 meter square. So 2.9 meter square of area is to be forged, then the cost of forging is 2.9 into 20, that is 20 rupees, that is cost of forging is 58 rupees. So this is the second problem on the forging. So here the problem, 150 pieces of shaft shown in figure are to be draw forged from raw stock of 2 cm diameter. Estimate the cost of forging. Here the some costs are given, that is the material cost 20 per meter. So cost of forging 120 rupees per meter square of forged. So overhead charges 100% of the cost of forging. Here this is the given diagram. So this is the 150 pieces of this shaft is going to be forged, that is draw forged. So draw forging is the machine forging. So in the previous problem it is clearly states that is hand forge, in the hand forge we are going to consider only scale and shear loss. Here in the draw forge all the losses to be considered to calculate the gross weight of the gross weight of the object. So here another material, here the stock, the raw stock of dam, diameter of the stock is to 2 centimeters. So there are 150 pieces to be manufactured, forged from the stock of 2 centimeters. So here this is the given object, given diagram. So by using the diagram we can easily calculate the net volume, then by adding the losses so we can calculate the gross volume. Here length of as it is, what is the length of stock should be maybe should be calculated by length of one piece for the forging of this type of object, that is gross volume of the piece base cross sectional area of stock. So here you can first should calculate the net volume. So net volume, this is the cylinder, this is cylinder shape, this is also cylinder. So 5 by 4 d square into l. So here 5 by 4 d square into d is 15. So l is equal to 70. Here d is 30. So all that I placed all the dimensions here in the mm only. So it is very, so that is the net volume we can obtain, that is 1,1905 mm³. Then we are going to calculate the gross volume by considering the losses. So here the losses, so shear loss is considered is 5%. So 5% of the net volume, since there the net volume already, this is the net volume 1,1905. So scale loss is considered as a 6%. So shear loss is assumed is a 5%, scale loss is 6%, and sprue loss is 7%. So here two losses are calculated in different way, that is tongue hold loss and flash loss. Tongue hold loss, so as I already explained, the tongue hold, the around 2 centimeters here in this I explained that. So around 2 centimeters, so this part may be removed, this may be 2 or 3 centimeters. So that's why, so 2 centimeters are, 2 centimeters means 20 mm. So 20 mm of the object may be inside the tongue. So the volume of that that material inside the, that the material inside the tongue should be, volume can be calculated by 5 by 4. So 20 square into 20, that is the diameter of the stock. Diameter of the stock is given as a, so 2 centimeters, that is 2 centimeters equal diameter of the stock is, so 20 and 20 square and 2 centimeters, that is 20 mm inside the tongue. So by calculating you can calculate tongue hold loss, this is the tongue hold. Next sprue loss is 7%. So flash loss, so flash loss means that is 20 mm wide. So whenever the flash loss is like that, this is the loss occur between the two dies, that is 20 mm wide, 3 mm thick, so around the periphery. So for the periphery means, so this is the periphery, so from periphery can be calculated from here, that is here, okay, you can, so here, so periphery is, this is 15, this is 70, this is, so this is 30, this is 15, then this is 7.5, this is 100, this is 20 and this is 30, then this is 5, this is 60, again this is 20, this is 5, this is 100, this is 7.5, this is 70. In this way you can calculate that. So here the values are posted, the 17 20 7.5, so all the values, that is 15 15 70 7.5 100, just like that. So this is 15 70 7.5 100. So around the periphery it is noted like this, that is 20 mm into 3 mm thickness, that is the flash loss. So you can calculate the, it is 3720. So these are the losses. The shear loss is considered as 5%, scale loss is 6%. So tongue hold loss is 2 centimeters of the, 2 centimeters of 20 mm of the stock inside the tong, and the sprue loss is considered as a 7%, flash loss 20 mm wide into 3 mm thick into the periphery. So after calculating all these losses, so simply you can calculate the gross volume. Gross volume is what? Net volume plus all the losses. All the losses here. So once all the losses are calculated, so then gross volume is calculated as a, so by adding the net volume plus losses here, this is the gross volume. Once the gross volume is calculated, you can calculate the length of the stock required for one piece of that piece. That is gross volume, that is 163,730 by cross sectional area of the stock, that is 5/4, 20 square. This is the 20 means that is that the diameter of the stock, that is 5/4 by into 20 square. That is, so here the piece, the length of the piece also calculate. Here all the dimensions are in mm, that's why the final dimension is 520 mm of length of piece required to make this object. So then, so this is for one piece. For 150 pieces, 521 mm plus 150, that is 78,158 mm. Then you can simply convert it in this value into meters. That is 78.17 meters of stock is required to made 150 pieces of this object. Here another, that is the material cost for 1 meter. 1 meter is equal to 20, so to rupees 20. Then 78 meters of the stock into 20, that is 156.35. so the cost of the material is 156. So another cost of forging, 120 per meter square of the, here another costs are, so cost of forging and overheads. So cost of forging, that is the 120 per, so meter square of forging. Here this is the diagram. Here the forging. Here forging is carried here. So hammering here. So pressure is applied here. So all these things. So you can calculate the areas. This is the cross sectional area. This is the surface area. So surface area means this is the surface area. This is the cross sectional area. So all the areas can be just like this. In the previous problem, it is calculated like this. This is the cross sectional area. This is the cross sectional 5/4d². This is the surface area pi dl. So like that, I placed here. That is the, for this 5/4d². This is pi dl. So here that is 5/4 for this part, 5/4d² plus pi dl plus for this one pi dl. This diameters may be changed. That is 1, 2 plus this is, oh okay, this one is the 5/4 this d square. That is here this is the 30 square minus this is the 15 square. Here also that is plus 5/4 this one 5/4 30 square minus 20 square plus this is the pi dl plus this is the cross sectional area 5/4d². In this way you can, guys, simply submitting all the values, you can get the surface of the forging. So forging surface, so as the cross sectional area comes in meter square, then the cost of the surface forging is equal to 120 meters. So here the surface forging, cross sectional area, that is the surface area, can be calculated by using this formula. So after getting the value, you can simply multiply into with this m square, that is values are comes in mm square. That is mm square. That mm square must be converted into meter square, as the cost of forging is given in 120 per meter square. So in order to convert the mm square into meter square, it is multiplied with 10 to the power of 6 only. So once the cost of forging is calculated, then another cost is overhead. That is 100% of the cost of forging. So if the cost of forging is 300, then overhead cost also 300. So then for calculating the total overall cost is called, material cost is already calculated 156.35. the cost of forging, suppose assumed this is 300, so overhead may be the reason. So total cost can be calculated like that.
Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe this channel and click on bell icon to get the notifications for the upcoming classes, and share this video.